Indian cinema has many pioneers who, in spite of huge challenges, crafted the art of storytelling. One such pioneer was Baburao Painter. He started filmmaking almost a decade after Phalke and gave a new grammar to Indian cinema. In today's episode of Not To Be Forgotten series, we look back at this versatile genius and explore how he revolutionized the craft of filmmaking in India. Born in a family of artisans on 3rd June 1890 in Kolhapur, Baburao Mistri was introduced to ivory carving and carpentry by his father Krishan Rao Mistri at a very young age. He got into painting and fine arts under the guidance of his cousin Anand Rao Painter and started calling himself Baburao Painter. On the instance of Kesharao Bhosle, Painter brothers went to Bombay and started working as set designers. A man of many talents, Baburao Painter juggled between painting, sculpting and set designing in Bombay and photography in Kolhapur at his father's studio. Baburao and his cousin Anand Rao were closely watching the influence of films on people. They desired to explore this new medium, but it needed a huge investment. Hence, they bought a film projector from a flea market and became exhibitor to remain connected and started learning filmmaking by watching them. Once they understood the science behind the 16 frames per second, they were all set to assemble their own camera. But as the fate would have it, Anand Rao died. Undeterred by this setback, Baburao went ahead with his cousin's dream and succeeded in assembling the camera. Initially, he, along with his assistants, made small documentaries to attract financiers. Fortunately, Tanebhai Kagalkar, a noted singer, helped them, and Maharashtra Film Company was established on 1st December 1918. In 1920, Baburao made his first feature film, Ser Andheri, based on K.P. Khadalkar's play. It centered around the evil Kechak and his lust for Draupadi, who was living as Sheradhari during the Agyatwas. Balasaheb Yadav was cast as Bheem and Zunzarao Pawar as Kechak. Gulab Bhai played Ser Andheri. The picturization of the killing of Kechak was so real that viewers used to scream in the theater. Hence, the scene had to be censored. Bal Gangadhar was very impressed by his style of filmmaking and conferred him the title of Cinema Kesari. The success of Ser Andheri was followed by Surekha Haran and Bhakta Damaji. However, a chance fire broke out in the studio of Maharashtra Film Company and destroyed all these films. With the work of last few years reduced to ashes, Painter was temporarily disheartened. However, with the rise of freedom struggle, he wanted to use films to awaken masses. He chose the stories having patriotic themes from history and started a series of historicals like Sinhagad, Kalyan Khajina, Sati Padmini, Rana Hamir, Shahala Shah, and Baji Deshpande. Sinhagad was India's first full-scale historical based on the life of Shivaji Maharaj and his lieutenant Tanaji. The shooting took place around Panhala Fort near Kolhapur, and more dramatic scenes which were shot indoor using artificial light. The splendor of Maratha and Mughal was assured with carpets, chandelier, shield, swords provided by Kolhapur aristocracy. The film was a roaring success, and so much so that British government had to introduce entertainment tax. While shooting, Baburao also suffered injuries which led to impaired speech for the rest of his life. Apart from historicals, one film which positioned him in history of Indian cinema is Savkari Pash, also known as Indian Shylock, made in 1925. This film anticipated the neorealism style of filmmaking, which was later popularized by Italian filmmakers. The story of Savkari Pash was about a farmer who is caught in debt trap of a village moneylender and moves to city where he became a mill worker. The audience, long fed on mythological and historical stories, was not prepared to this strong dose of realism, and hence film failed commercially. He also made his share of mythologicals like Vatsala Haran, Shri Krishna Avatar, Bhakt Prahlad, Gaj Gauri, Murli Wala, Sati Savitri, and Lanka. His last silent film was a fantasy, Prem Sangam. Two of his films, Sinhagad and Kalyan Khajina, were shown at London's Wembley exhibition and won him medal. However, with the advent of sound, Babu Rao was not interested in making talkies because he thought it will destroy the visual culture. His associates V. Shantaram, V. G. Damle and Sheikh Fateh Lal went on to establish the Prabhat Film Company, and finally Maharashtra Film Company pulled its shutters down. Painter went to retirement as far as filmmaking was concerned, but he continued his original vocation, painting and sculpture. He was pulled out by his well-wishers few times to make talkies. In 1934, he made a sound-synchronized version of his silent film Prem Sangam. Usha, Pratibha and Savkari Pash were made for Shalini movie tone. He made Sadhvi Meerabai starring Bal Gandharva. He also made Rukmani Swayamvar in 1946. Lok Shahir Ram Joshi was made jointly with his disciple V. Shantaram. Vishwamitra in 1956 can be called as his last movie. Indian cinema owes this genius in more than one way. He imparted a new grammar to films in different genres like historical, mythology, fantasy, and social realism. His filmmaking used to be aesthetically perfect with authentic feel. He tried best to show realistic effect on the screen. To achieve this, he made many advancements such as three-dimensional rounded set designs, use of colors to give various shades in the screen, used tinted glasses as filters for night scene, shot films with artificial lights, and used fade-in and fade-out techniques to join shots. Babu Rao Painter's contribution is also about discovering and training a cadre of technicians and artists under the Maharashtra Film Company. He single-handedly gave Hindi and Marathi industry more than 250 to 300 personnel in various departments. V. Shantaram, S. Fateh Lal, Keshav Rao Dhaibar, V. G. Damle, Babu Rao Pendharkar, Bhai Ji Pendharkar, and actors like Master Vittal, Zunzun Rao Pawar and Ganpat Bakre were few of his disciples. He even commissioned film booklets and pamphlets as publicity material in the film industry by painting tastefully eye-catching posters for each film and sketched costumes to ease the process of shooting. Babu Rao Painter was an accomplished filmmaker, painter, sculptor, and a great teacher. He was an affectionate man who was admired by not only his colleagues, but everyone who met him. He died on 16th January 1954 in Kolhapur at the age of 64. If Dada Saheb Phalke is considered father of Indian cinema, then Babu Rao Painter was undoubtedly its godfather. And Cinemazi pays its tribute to this forgotten legend.